This is worth a whiff. Let's talk Jo Malone. Hello, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching, I'm Sheree, welcome. And if you are returning, you are truly appreciated and thank you so much, you guys. Today, I'm sharing with you, of course, Jo Malone. I know the lights are super bright, you can't see, but this is Jo Malone. I picked up a new fragrance and I'll tell you how I stumbled upon this fragrance. So last year at this time, I went in there and I got picked up Wedge Sage and Sea Salt. Oh my God, it's so good and it's perfect for this time of year. So this year I went in, well last year, okay, Sheree, focus. Last year when I went in, I got Wood Sage and Sea Salt, and they gave me a ton of samples, as they always do, and they gave me one particular one that I took with me on vacation, and it was called Pomegranate Noir, and it smelled so good. I wore it in Vegas. It was in August, so it was kind of hot, but it was the only one that I had, so I sprayed it, and I wore it, and I was like, oh my God, I really like this. So when I went in this time, you already know what I picked up. I already took off the ribbon. You guys know they have nice packaging, nice ribbons. They always give great samples and everything like that. So I did go in, and I did pick up the, what is this, the 30 mil? One fluid ounce, yeah, it's a 30 mil. This retails for about $70. You can also pick this up at Sephora. They do carry it at Sephora. However, I'm an experienced girl and I love going to the actual like perfume counters or perfume houses or the boutique or whatever. I just like the luxury that it gives you. You get to smell all the fragrances and then they have all the samples and the lotions and the body creams and the body oils, and she's that girl. So that's why I always love to go to the actual stores themselves. So this here is Pomegranate Noir. On the Jo Malone website, it has this categorized as what? Fruity. And I guess the pomegranate would be more fruity, but I myself get more warm, spicy. I get more like a little sexy. Yes, I do. Dare I say it? I think it's a little sensual. I think it's perfect for day to night, but I really like it in the evening. I really like it for going out for events. I think it's very like fancy, but not like too fancy. It's kind of, it would be good for a date night scent. It would be good for just like if you're just going somewhere. You know how a lot of times right now we're gonna have like gatherings, like Friendsgiving, and you're gonna be going to like Christmas parties and different things like that. This is a great scent to wear that when you go in and you hug somebody and you just greet them, it smells really nice. It's really appeasing. I don't think it's too loud. It's not off-putting. I particularly really like it. So if you guys have not smelled Pomegranate Noir, get your nose on this, and it's, yeah, it's, I'm gonna wear this today. Actually, I should have not worn this today, but you know what? I love this scent. It's so holiday-ish. It's warm, it's spicy. Oh my God, it makes me get so excited because it just, it reminds me of the holidays. Let me give you a feel of the, let me give you a few of the notes before I get way too excited. It's pomegranate. It has a Casablanca lily. It's got a little bit of woods in it. It's just a warm, woody, spicy, get by the fire, get ready to play games, get ready to see your friends, your loved ones, and just have a good time. That's what this fragrance does. It screams holiday, and I love it. And then I also got the candle because this is the Pomegranate Noir candle as well. I got this one last year as well. The candles are really good, and they burn very well. You can light this downstairs if you're gonna have friends coming over or if you just wanted to get the house. To me, it's a holiday scent, more holiday, warm, spicy, woody, ready, crackling of the fire, the people were coming over. This is nice. Even if you were cooking, this is a scent that goes nice with it because of the pomegranate and the warm, woody, spicy. It wouldn't be off-putting. It wouldn't be loud. It's just a very nice, what would you say, comfort type of fragrance, and it's very inviting. So if you love Jo Malone candles or you haven't tried them, they burn very well and they smell up the entire home. If I burn this downstairs, I can smell it upstairs as well. So if you're looking for candles, this is a great one to try. Oh, and then they gave me two, the pomegranate hand cream. I love that. They gave me two, one for my smaller bag and one for my larger bag. So can't go wrong with that. They do have a new fragrance, you guys. This fragrance is called, wait, let me get my notes because you know I will make some names up. I will make some names up. This one is called Poppy and Barley. Poppy and Barley. I don't know much about barley. I really don't know much about poppy. I will tell you how the fragrance smells. They did give me these cute little samples. So let's smell it. I wore it. I did a wear test on it. It's better to me once it dries down. Some of the notes that it has in it, rose. I wrote myself a little note here saying make sure you let them know that it does smell like rose. Not a loud rose, like a very floral kind of rose. More of a rose that you would receive on like Valentine's Day. Like a dark, heavy red rose that it would smell like to me. You can smell that especially in the dry gown. Another note is black currant. I love black currant. That is heavily in this fragrance. And barley. And believe it or not, you do smell the barley. I don't know what beer smells like, you guys. I've never had beer, but I think it smells, I've seen people with beer and I've smelled that suzz or whatever that bubble stuff is on top. And it has some of that, I don't know if beer has barley in it. Don't ask me how I'm drawing these conclusions, okay? I'm just giving you what it smells like to me. I wouldn't purchase it, but I think it's a place and there's a person for it. It's not particularly my scent. It would do nothing for me, but it is nice. I'm not gonna spray it on me because I don't wanna mix it. I will say that none of the Jo Malone fragrances are very, very long lasting, and that's why to me they're so perfect to pair and layer with other Jo Malone fragrances or other fragrances. The Pomegranate Noir, that one has longevity. It lasts, especially if you layer it with the lotion. So I will say that one. This one here was okay as well. It's nice. I smell a little bit of green in there too though. I don't know. It's nice. It's a safe fragrance. It's perfect for the holidays. It's perfect for right now, for the season, for, you know, everything that it is. The cold, you know, this is something to spray on. Where would you wear this to, Sheree? I would wear this to anywhere. It's one of those. It's an anytime, anywhere. It's not a double take. It's not a sexy date night. It's not get your entire life. It's not doing the most. It's not doing a lot. It's just doing a fragrance. So it is nice. If you want something, they have it categorized in the fruity floral. Like I said, you do smell the black currant, you do get a lot of the rose, especially in the dry down. I mean, it really is a nice fragrance, and I will just categorize it and leave it right there under a nice fragrance. There is somebody that will love this though, but if you spray this too much, I would hate to be stuck in an elevator with you. That's all I'm gonna say. So I'm gonna leave that there. It's worth getting your nose. It's worth giving a whirl. What did we say we were gonna call that on the channel? Oh my god, I forgot. Worth a whiff. Oh, that's it, you guys. It's worth the whiff. So I would say it's worth the whiff. One of the subscribers named it that. I think her name is Juliet. I could be making it up, or Angelique. One of the two. It's worth a whiff. So get your nose on that if you're looking for something safe that you could wear anytime, any place. Okay, Sheree, move on. Another one, and this is the last one that they gave me. This is gonna be really quick because for me, it was a no. This is called English Oak and Red Currant. Am I saying that right? I'm making that up. English Oak and Red Currant. You guys, this was a no, no, and bigger no for me. I sprayed it on and it's very complex, okay? When you first spray it, it's just like, what in the world? Seriously, like not even exaggerating, in my opinion. Okay, I have myself a handy dandy note here because I was like, what is this? It is categorized as a floral fruity. The notes that it has in it is red currant, rose, and it has red oak. I don't know what red oak smells like. I don't know what notes, you guys. Sometimes when I watch a lot of perfume reviews or talk to, you know, the perfumers in the store and they give me all the notes, I go, I don't understand any of that because I don't know what barley smells like, nor do I know what poppy smells like, nor do I know what roasted oak smells like, okay? What does it make you feel? Who's wearing this? Where are you wearing it to? That's what I wanna know. So that's what I'm going to deliver to you today. She does fragrance a little differently. Anyhow, so here's this. This is red oak and, no it's not. It's English oak and red currant. There it is. Oh my gosh. The opening to me is citrusy. It's kind of green. What in the world is this? It's got white, oh, no wonder, here's some of the notes. Huh, it has, it's white musk, green, mandarin, rose. It's fresh, it is fresh, I will give it that. The opening is fresh. Now here's what I will say, and I have to be fair. I'm gonna judge this fragrance fair. In the beginning, when you first spray it, you do get complexity. You just get like, where in the world am I placing this? Where's this going? What is this doing? However, as it dries down, it lightens up. You can actually smell the rose in this as well. It gets very light though. It comes across like it's gonna be in your face and kinda loud, but as it simmers down on the body and dries down, it becomes very light after about 2 hours. And then I went back and smelt my arm again and it was like non-existent. It was faintly there, but not really. And in the beginning, when you first spray it, you think it's gonna be very strong and very in your face, but it dies down. It's nice, there's a place for this. It's just not a place for it in my life. But I do think, is it worth the whiff? Not in my opinion, but everybody is different. So to you, it may be worth the width. For me, it's a no. You guys, this is my new addition to my Jo Malone collection, Pomegranate Noir, and I will say get your nose on this. This is definitely worth the width. I love it. Like I said, the candle, you can't go wrong. And then the hand cream, layering them up, it just pairs for an amazing, beautiful scent, especially around this time of year. I wanna know what fragrances you wear around the holidays. There are so many different fragrances in the store right now, you guys. There are so many different ones. They're getting the holidays ready, where the holidays are approaching us. So they're sending out their Christmas packaging where you get the lotion, the body oil, the body gel, or the shower gel. So there's gonna be tons of different fragrances being launched. I did smell one by Gucci, and it has a new one out. It's in a red bottle. It's a part of the Bloom family. It smells really nice. It was way too close to Gucci Bloom, but it does have a different note in there, but not enough to stand out for me. I know that there's another one. Tiffany came out with one. Who else came out with one? Oh my God, just so many different places came out with one. Valentino came out with one that I smelled that was really, really good. It's a pink, I think it's part of their Donnarumma collection, and that one smelled really good. I sprayed it on, it's kind of sexy. It's got some black currant in there as well, a little bit of vanilla that I smell. So those are nice. If there's any fragrances that you like from me to review on the channel, please leave it in the comment section below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on your way out if you like the vibe and you want to subscribe. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to hit the like button. Thank you for showing up and watching my videos. You are truly appreciated. Until next time, guys, you know the drill. Be blessed, stay fit, and definitely stay fabulous. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.